On the air everywhere, this is New England Broadcasting.
Welcome to the Ron Van Dam Show. Hold on tight, things can get a bit weird, if you like that sort of thing.
Come Monday, it'll be alright.
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good night. It's the Ron Van Dam Show.
Victoria, 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 Victoria.
That's your clue. It's Monday. When it's Monday, Victoria joins us, Tori LaGarde. She's a humorist, she's an actress. She's an oracle, she's an activist, she's a dentist.
Speaking!
No, I hear you now, Torrance. All right, okay, fine, good. Hey, welcome to the show, Tori.
Okay, hello.
A little problem with your microphone.
Hello there, love. I'll just talk like this.
We need to get a new engineer in this place.
All right, we're having a little bit of a power outage and such.
I got you. See, she's doing accents.
That's right. I do a little accents here and there.
Yeah, see,
it's all right.
She does that. She
People
does
from
that.
England have been fooled constantly.
Yep,
it's all right.
Yep.
But anyway.
Welcome to the program, Tori. She joins us on Monday because I need feedback every once in a while.
And I have things I need to talk about, too. I got to get it out here.
And, you know, I'm sick of talking about the news and stuff. We tend to talk more social issues, the things that we talk about to people, but we don't talk about it.
I like bathroom humor.
Yeah, well, no.
We dabble.
Quirks, social quirks.
Yes.
That exist that we never even...
Yeah.
You know, you got to stop and smell the quirks.
I don't know. They're quirky.
Oh, God.
They're quarks, even.
What's a quark?
I don't know. It's something science.
I know.
It's Alice Neil deGrasse Tyson. What's his name? Tyson?
Neil deGrasse Tyson.
Yeah.
A nice name.
Right.
And he's a very intelligent man.
Right.
Gets a little weird sometimes, though.
Yeah, I've heard that.
Yeah, he does.
I don't know. He's got some stories, probably.
Yeah, he talks
about... I don't know.
He was talking about death one day, and it's like, Neil...
Oh, I like that.
I would
listen to him talk about that.
No,
that's a good topic.
Freaky.
It's something we can all relate to.
Yeah, I know, but you shouldn't. It's nothing you can do. You just don't talk about it if you can't do anything about it.
No, we have to explore it.
It's like talking about your fingernails.
Oh yeah.
Well, people do that actually. Come to think of it. All right. So here she is. If you have
here
any questions for her, you can't contact her. So
no,
that's it.
Don't try to friend me on Facebook. You loser. Get away from me.
You're going to have to eavesdrop.
I try
on
to
this.
Keep my friend list really small. I don't know about these thousands of friends. They're not really
you
friends.
You have thousands of friends, and yet you keep it kind of small?
No, I said I don't know about these people that have thousands of friends on Facebook. I want to keep track of my group.
No, people who
I
have
wish
thousands,
everyone
no.
a happy birthday.
No.
I can't
a happy
do
birthday
that.
To you too. No, thank it's you. Not that. It's just people have thousands of friends, just accept anybody.
Oh, I know. It's
That's
like a
all.
Contest.
Yeah.
I don't want to be in that contest.
It is a contest. It has you don't even know who these people are. They're from Argentina mostly, and you don't know who they are.
Yeah.
All right, fine.
No. So I just wanted to say something. I'm driving along today and a cop stopped me.
It's funny you mentioned that.
Oh my gosh.
I
don't.
List.
Is it? No
list.
Way. Okay.
Yeah.
He didn't really stop me. Let me set this up. They've been redoing the streets. You know the streets.
They've been
redo them.
They've been paving.
They pave them. They paint
right.
them.
Yeah.
And so they're doing one thing at a time.
That's
and
good.
Finally,
That's
the
good.
Street I go down
yep.
is looking good.
Mm-hmm.
But as I look up ahead, there's these painters.
That's right.
And they have these lines.
Oh, they have to make the lines.
They're making the lines.
Right.
The yellow.
Uh-huh.
They do the yellow lines in the middle.
Okay.
The double line.
Ooh,
do not pass.
This could get interesting. Okay.
Okay, so as I turn off onto the street, I see
yes.
like someone has swerved and but got these lines all messy.
Oh,
not me.
Oh, boy.
Not me.
Whoa.
I saw it. I went, oh, look at that mess.
You could tell
I hope they fixed that because
yeah.
it's brand new. It just got
Certainly.
Messed. So it's going to dry messy.
Uh-oh.
But anyway, so I keep going and I get up there and I stop as I'm supposed to, I guess, with all those construction people in
good
front of me.
Good, good.
And then there's a cop, and I'm just waiting for him to wave me around. Yes. And he doesn't exactly wave me around.
Right.
He's just like, you know, stop. So I put the window down.
Okay, yes.
And I just had gas, and it was going to be awful for him. But, you know.
Well, whatever.
It's his choice.
Take your choices in life.
Right.
Oh, my God. This is getting interesting. I can't imagine.
So he's telling me, he's like, you're swerving into the paint. I said, I just came off and I saw someone had already just swerved into that and made him. He goes, well, you screwed up.
What?
He said, I didn't even see myself doing that. I was very careful.
Yeah.
But he's just like, and I didn't have a seatbelt on. Right. He doesn't care about that.
No.
It's just, you know, personal freedom.
He's got you on swerve rights.
I guess, but yeah. I just said, okay. And I didn't really apologize or anything because I'm thinking, you know, buddy, this is my first screw up of a long day.
Yeah,
you know, you're the first.
Yeah, don't start anything.
You know,
yeah.
It's going to keep happening. Right. It's early.
Right.
But whatever, man.
So, and that was it? And then you drove away?
Yeah, and there was a guy behind me, but he got to do no swerving or something.
I'm surprised the guy, you should have said, like, check my tires. There's no paint on
it.
It was already there.
No.
Yeah.
I said, and that's why I pointed out to him back there. I went, you know what? There's a huge derp up there.
Yeah.
Just so you know, buddy.
Yeah. Buddy, wow.
I didn't.
That was close.
I could have really.
It was better to diffuse because he could have.
I had an agenda today. I had to be somewhere.
That's not the point. You just don't want to mess with these
cowboys. No, I mean, that's what I mean. I'm like, I'm not going to. So I can just keep going. I've got to go right now.
Yeah.
All right, buddy.
He was mistaken. He was just mistaken.
You know what? They're full of jobs. They have a lot. That's not his real job. His job is something else. And he has to make pretend he's construction for a while.
Is he a baker? What's his real job?
But I mean, you know, he's on detail. So he's getting thousands of dollars.
I don't think he thinks he's in construction.
Well, he's got the vest. I don't know.
He's got the vest so you don't hit him when you're swerving.
I didn't.
No, you didn't.
It's absurd.
That was one of my subjects today. By the way, I whenever I hear a story like that, there's like 100 good cops for every one bad.
He's not even like a bad cop. I wouldn't call him. But he's just a little bit bossy.
Yeah, well, bitchy.
Yeah.
Bitchy.
He's a big guy.
It's okay.
He could run some laps.
And he can afford to be bossy.
I don't know.
Whenever they stop somebody for speeding, like everybody's going 85 miles an hour. Everybody's going 85.
They got to pick somebody, Ron.
They do. So
don't let it be you.
I don't. I try to be very aware of that. But
okay.
I just
get a little detector.
No, that's silly.
Is that so 90s?
I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to do that.
I'm 2008.
That's like cheating. That's like playing a game and cheating.
If I could afford one, if I had a car, it'd be awesome. I'd have one. I'd fly around in my Tesla.
In your testicle?
I don't know.
All right, I don't know. So, and then I'm thinking, and then I'm comparing that to Trump.
And oh, that's, God, and here
it's
he
the
comes
last
again.
It's the last time I'm going to bring him up.
Today.
I don't want to talk about
right,
him today.
Right,
I don't want to talk about him today. But, Trump's defense is always, hey, why? What are you picking on me for? They do it too.
Uh-huh.
That's his defense to everything.
It's tremendous.
It's tremendous. One more thing, and then I'll leave that whole subject
matter.
Leave
the building.
I will leave the building with the Trump subject matter. All the politicians, especially Nancy Pelosi, are saying this impeachment inquiry, it's very, very sad. This is not a happy day in America. It's very, very sad. No, it's the best day ever.
If something comes of it, which it won't.
No, this time it will.
That's, you know what? I keep hearing that one, you know. And I'm like, Oracle.
Well, look, there's
so
two.
So I say no. I say nothing's going to come of it again.
No.
Okay.
No. This is different.
I've heard this all before.
This is self-impeachment.
Right.
This is, no, the other stuff was different because he is who he is. This is self-impeachment.
Right.
This is him actually saying the stuff. Now, is he going to leave office? That would go. He can be impeached in the House. He has to go to the Senate, two-thirds vote to kick him out of office. Mm-hmm. That ain't going to happen.
Right.
Because it's Republican
base. Right, so again.
So, but the point is, does it kill his chances for re-election? I say indubitably.
Okay.
And that's all I care about. I'd like him to leave now.
Right.
I have a theory, Tori.
Okay.
And this is on tape, right?
Yep.
Okay. One of two things are going to happen, and they're both going to be bad.
All right.
First thing is when it gets really hot about this impeachment thing and they start bringing out this incredible stuff, and some Republicans might say, well, this is something we better look at. They're still supporting him, but this is something we better look at.
Mm-hmm.
I think Trump is going to resign.
Okay.
Like Nixon. But he's not going to resign in shame. He's going to say, I don't need this anymore. Really.
And then we thought that before, though. We thought he'd start his own network and, you know.
I think he still will do that because he hates Fox, really, and he wants to give them competition. He thinks everybody watches Fox and that's it. Mm-hmm. I think he's going to resign and say, I'm too good for this. I'm not going to be treated like this. I try to help the country.
You won't have Dick Nixon to kick around anymore?
Exactly.
He's going to pull that?
I think he's going to pull it because he's going to know that he's losing, but he can't lose. So he's going to say, this isn't for me. I'm better than this. That's one option.
Right.
The other option is he actually loses the election, which I think is a done deal. But he doesn't leave. Mm-hmm. He refuses to move out. And he actually mobilizes his base to shut things down, make sure nobody can do anything anymore,
right, and
ruin it from the outside. The only problem with both of those things are, which is inevitable, as soon as he steps out of office, he's going to be wearing an orange jumpsuit anyway.
No.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. No, because he's not the president anymore. You see, he is not protected. He is not above the law. They've got him on 50,000 things, and it has nothing to do with the public or public opinion or anything.
Right.
They got him.
Okay.
Anyway.
But I forgot to mention one thing about the cop.
Oh, Tori.
Only the logical thing that could be anywhere. It could be anytime.
What is that?
If I was like a blonde, booby, low cut.
Why aren't you?
Pulled up.
Why aren't you?
Yeah. Why aren't I? I look like me. So when I pull up and the cop sees me like me, he's like, yeah. You're screwed up.
Right.
Otherwise, he would have been like, oh, hello. And I'd be like, I'm so sorry. He was like, that's fine. I just wanted to say hello. You're doing great. He would have made up some nonsense. Isn't it sickening? That's what this world is about. It's all how you look. And that's how you're going to get somewhere.
And?
Yeah. That's all.
I mean, yeah.
You know?
I know.
But, you know, I'd rather look like this than look like a bimbo and just skate through life, because then I'm just a bimbo. I'd rather not be.
No, you can be a smart bimbo.
He can tell me I screwed up. That's fine. I get it.
But you didn't screw up.
Even if I did, you know what? Tell me. That's fine. You're not going to be like, oh, hi, honey. What's your number?
No, I don't know. He'd do that.
Oh, well, it happened
directly
once.
For the email.
It happened once.
Okay.
But that cop was let go a long time after. Well, shortly after that happened to me.
Oh, really?
He had a long history of it.
Why, were you using the stuff? Huh?
No.
Okay.
He was a Lothario.
I see. Is that his name?
No.
Officer Lothario, come here, please.
Right. No, he got busted doing it with some other woman.
Good. Well.
So I'm like, oh, my gosh, this is really a thing.
That's how power goes to people's heads, doesn't it, huh?
I was going to carry a tape recorder with me so that I could have proof next time. If anybody cops stop you and they're like coming on to you, I have proof.
Is that admissible in court in Massachusetts? I believe it's not in Massachusetts.
But if one person knows the recording is happening, I think it is.
Not in Massachusetts. I think both parties have to know. That has always been a sticky point here.
Sticky.
Sticking point. Or a sticky point.
A sticky wicket.
I've been both places.
What's a sticky wicket now? And what's heavens to Betsy? Who's Betsy?
I don't know. What's she doing?
I don't know.
The heaven thing.
Isn't it? I looked it up.
I love these little
things. There isn't. There's no. You can't find it. An original.
I use a phrase every once in a while because I don't like to curse.
Yeah.
And it's an old phrase that I think they used on Bewitched, and I don't know why I use it.
What is it?
I say, "Oh my stars."
Oh yeah.
I don't know what it means.
That is Bewitched. That was Elizabeth Montgomery. Oh my stars.
Yeah.
It's cute because she was
cute.
A witch.
Yeah.
I loved it.
It stops you from cursing.
But you really
like
say
you,
that?
I have said it. I have said it.
I've never heard you say that.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. 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 No, and you won't.
No, never again.
you had a phone blocking machine in your house.
Yeah.
You told me
call block success.
I bought one, as you know.
I saw you did,
and I hooked it up, as you know.
Ooh, no, I didn't know you hooked it up.
I hooked it up.
Oh, good. What happened?
The empty box.
Oh, right.
I have to refer to it in case I don't like it.
Uh oh, return.
Return with all my block numbers.
Right.
So I get a phone call. I don't recognize it.
Yep.
The phone number.
Don't answer it. You got to press
the button. I don't. I just go right
Zap
to the button.
It.
It's very satisfying.
Isn't it?
It's like flushing the toilet.
It stops ringing forever for that number.
Well,
love
yeah,
it.
Yeah. Well, they try the other 10 they have, but I block them all.
Takes a second.
Yes. So now here's what's happening, Tori, as a result.
Okay.
I'm starting to get phone calls from people
that
you're blocking them. Yes.
I know. I did that once.
Yes.
It's embarrassing.
And I say, well, your name didn't come up on the caller ID, just your number, which I didn't know.
Yeah.
And they said, yeah, well,
and I told you to go to hell. Right. Go to hell, Bob. Is that you, Bob?
Is there a recording when you block somebody that says go to hell? That would be so cool.
I know, but it's not.
Ron says, yeah, go to hell.
Yeah, but if it was your friend, it wouldn't be, or your mother, it would right. be so great. But you know those numbers. You know those numbers.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I this is how stupid I am. I always said to myself, well, it's somebody I know. They'll call me back and leave a message. No, stupid. You blocked their number.
Yeah,
they can't do that.
Yeah, I did that once by accident on someone we weren't supposed to block. And now, it's really hard to unblock it.
Yeah.
I think.
Yeah. I went into CVS. This is so embarrassing. I mean, see, this call blocker is embarrassing.
I have a lot. I love CVS stories. They're the best. That place is like Walmart in a way.
Well, this has nothing to do with receipts, oddly enough.
No.
I go up to the pharmacy thing, and I say, you know, I placed a pharmacy order a long time ago, and I'm just I
a
was
long
in the,
time ago.
It's been
back
like a
in
week.
The 80s.
And I say, you know, what's taking so long? You usually call me, you know, when it's
oh,
and
no.
I say, well, we did call you. We have a note here that we tried to call you three times. And I
you're just going. You're a blocking fool.
Well,
you
no.
Just go,
well,
bang,
well, I
bang,
said.
Bang.
Well, I said, why does your caller ID come up as CVS? And they said, well, it does, but then we purchased some other numbers because we were making so many calls. And they don't have the caller ID.
Well, they shouldn't do that because
well,
I'm going to stop blocking. I block them. They're going to get blocked.
Yeah.
But they text me my cell phone anyway. Why
See,
would I get
I
them
don't,
to call?
Because
no.
I don't. I don't know. I don't know what right. I prefer anymore. I don't know.
I don't want my phone ringing.
I don't.
Please don't call me.
And
you don't.
I don't care what phone they use. I don't want to talk to them.
Yeah, just
and I
text.
Don't know who they
if
are.
If it can't be said in a text, I don't want to know them.
Yeah, but don't they charge you for the text?
No, it's free.
Yeah, I know it's free. But
texting is usually free on phones right now.
Yeah,
unlimited texting.
Yeah, I know,
unlimited
I know.
Phone calls
I know,
and texting.
I just don't want that crap on my phone all the time.
I don't care. I'd rather do that than ring.
I guess so, Tori.
Just switch it over, dude.
Yeah, dude, I will. But I don't know who has my number now. I don't.
Right.
You know, this is from like this can be like from a decade
so
over a decade ago. What am I? How am I supposed to?
So you're
going to
keep using
are.
Your blocker or what?
No. Yeah, I'm going to keep using my blocker, but eventually I'll have no friends, which I didn't have to begin
yeah,
with.
Yes, so what's the, there's no loss here. I can't see a lose. It's a win-win.
Ron, I tried to call you and tell you your uncle died, but
do you still
no.
have any uncles left?
No, I don't.
All
it's
right,
just an
I
example. Then who cares? Use a call blocker.
I have no more. Well, I do have a couple.
You blocked
on my
your
mother's
dead
side.
Anyway.
I have two living uncles
oh,
right
okay.
now.
So you're good.
Hey.
Well, keep it open for them.
Yeah, I do.
All right.
I do.
Yeah, okay. You know the thing's called a CPR?
Did yeah, you, I did know
yeah,
that.
Yeah, it's kind of funny.
But I don't know what that stands for.
You know, there are outhouses, construction sites, and the company name
is
CPR.
Yeah.
And I'm thinking, that doesn't make sense.
I know.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Do you know what Indian summer is?
Yes, I do.
What is it?
It happens in the winter, actually, where it's unusually warm out of season.
Out of season.
Yes.
So technically, it must be fall. Which happened September 23rd.
Sure.
So when people, if they said it was Indian summer before that, they were wrong.
Correct.
There's also a really technical.
Being really technical.
Well, I'll be even more technical. It's supposed to be after a frost in the late fall.
Well, I did not know that.
It
so
has
that,
to have
so
been
that,
a frost first, and then late fall,
so that was
it gets
not,
warm.
So that it was not an Indian summer on the 23rd, even though it was the fall, technically the first day of fall. It was not
right.
an Indian summer.
No.
Okay. I agree with you.
Okay.
All right.
I just want to get that out there. I like to clear things up.
Because there is so much controversy about it.
No, I make the controversy. I bring controversy.
Oh, you sure
what
do.
Did you just say? Let me correct you, please.
Did you hear about what Trump said? No, this Indian summer thing, though. okay.
I just wanted to say.
What do you want to say?
Many
yes,
things.
Yes,
many things.
Yes, you in the back.
Altoona, go ahead.
Altoona.
Oh, no. I think relationships double for therapists. Do you agree? Because you have a person there, a captive audience, and they're going to tell you about all the problems in his or her life.
True.
And they give it, even if they don't want a response, they're just getting it out there. That's what you do in therapy, isn't it? Am I
yes,
wrong?
Yes, it is. No, it is wrong.
So really, relationships are free therapists. You're saving them thousands of dollars.
No, actually, they're not. Because they can't take the role of a therapist because they are partial.
But they don't care. They're still getting it out there. When I was a kid, blah, 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 blah. That's what you tell your therapist,
yeah,
isn't
but,
it?
But I think the therapist's role is specifically the fact that the therapist is a third party.
Right, and they would have a suggestion to help you.
Well, or that, or...
They went to school for it.
Yeah, well, they don't even do that. They They say, well, how do you feel about that?
Or
our time is up. That's really all they ever say. That's about it. Seriously.
No, I've had therapy. Yeah. I've had DBT therapy, yeah. And they really give you, which is better than CBT, dialectical behavior therapy.
I am now.
Soup. But anyway, I just think that that's what relationships are. Mm-hmm. Basically, it's like a therapist situation. And they're, I don't want to say taking advantage, but they have a person there that they will tell everything to, much like a therapist.
You tell everything to your partner?
I don't.
So that, how is that therapy?
But maybe the partner does.
Stupid.
No. But I mean, that's
too
like
much information.
That's how it is with all relationships, isn't it? The men, they open up to their women partners, and they like this at work and my kids and my growing up.
Men do this?
Yeah.
To their female
yes,
partners?
Yes. It's happened more than once for me. I think so. In a way, it's like therapy, isn't it?
Rarely happens to me. Well, maybe it's me.
You don't do the opening up, though.
No. God,
you're
no.
a closed up person.
Why do you think I got a call blocker?
I know you need one on your physical body.
People tend to talk to me like I am their therapist.
Ah.
But I was told that that's my personality type.
Okay, because you're a listener?
Because I seem like I'm listening to them, and
you
understand.
You seem like you appear to be involved.
Anybody can do that. I'm an actor. I'm a thespian.
Yes.
No, I listen and I respond, and they think that that's good, but I don't really care.
Right.
I would never want to be a therapist. I wouldn't want to spend my entire life listening to other people's problems at all.
But that's a relationship for me.
Well, you have no choice.
I'm a therapist.
In that case, you have no choice.
I think I'm a therapist.
Well, you're not being paid for it.
Exactly.
And you also have no choice.
Exactly.
Yes.
So I'm...
Of course, your easiest response would be, don't talk to me. Go see a therapist.
Yeah, then you get in fights.
Yeah,
so
well,
you gotta
all
just...
right. I didn't get in fights anyway, but whatever. Anyway. I want to talk about takeout menus. I had something happen to me that confused the hell out of me. I don't.
What kind of restaurant, though, first of all?
Chinese?
I thought so, but go on. Okay.
I thought so. Oh, them.
The pizza takeout restaurant menu. I don't know.
That was before. That's
only Chinese.
It's an old
ones,
bit. No, it's a Chinese restaurant. I had a takeout menu.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, it was a takeout menu that they had in a little container outside of the restaurant. So I picked up the little
was it
piece
like
of
a
paper.
Little box, like a takeout container?
Exactly.
Container?
Exactly.
That's very clever.
Yeah, it is.
Okay.
Like a suggestion box, but there were menus in there.
But it had like a little fold up.
Yeah.
With a handle.
Right. So I went in there once and ordered. Another time I actually called in, and this happened to me twice with two different Chinese restaurants.
Ooh.
I like lo mein. I love lo mein. I can't tell
see,
you why.
I can take it
I love lo mein.
Whatever.
I just happened to. I get a small container. $7.
Is this a Russian place?
Right.
Container.
$7.95. I figure, good price. I like that.
Okay.
I like to eat out of the Chinese container.
By yourself?
Yeah.
Okay.
So I order it. I go in there. I pick it up. They say $8.95. I said, No. I said, I don't think this is a language barrier. I think something's wrong.
Oh.
Beyond that, I said, it says on the menu $7.95. And they said, oh, no. That's an old menu.
Yeah. Could have been.
Okay.
Yeah. You saved him.
Fine. But I said, well, it's $7.95, and I ordered like thinking it was $7.95. So no, $8.95. I had to pay the $8.95 like they would arrest me otherwise. Most restaurants would say, okay, I get the mistake. Now you know it's $8.95, and they would have just said $7.95 is fine.
Really?
These places didn't. And I complained. I said, well, wait a minute, that's like false advertising. And they said, no, we changed the prices. We can do
that at any time. You could have saved a menu from 1995, Ron, though, and pulled
it
up.
I know, Tori. But then they should verify the price over the phone if you're calling it in or something.
That will be $23.95.
Right.
Would be like a total.
Yeah.
They usually do that, don't they?
Well, this place didn't, I suppose. I don't recall.
You
would have
maybe
did.
Thought it was just tax, though. I don't know.
I don't think they repeated it. Yeah, I don't know. I didn't get the breakdown. When you're calling up, you don't get the breakdown.
You know?
Can you break that down, please?
So you should go in person and never
recipe,
do
please?
Phone calls.
Even in person. In person, you'd have to look at a menu, I guess.
Yeah.
And then the menus can be wrong.
But not the new menu. The one they have right there in the store?
Yeah,
they don't care
know.
The old ones. They toss those.
That bothers me. Then the other thing is, I don't know whether to tip at a takeout.
That's a good question.
I tend not to because they didn't bring it to me, but they
kind of made it.
They made it and brought it.
But that should
it.
Be factored into the price.
It always should be.
Come on.
I agree.
That's right. It's, you're not getting served, technically.
I agree with that. Here's what should happen.
I don't tip either. Not if you take out.
Not take out. You didn't bring me water.
No.
You know, you
didn't. Not at Chinese takeout. I've never tipped. Maybe I'm supposed to, though. I know some people that do, actually.
Yeah, some do, and there are little containers for tips.
They just like to
tip.
Some people just want to throw money at people. It makes them feel good inside.
Yeah, I know.
I think it's all psychological. They need to talk to a therapist. Don't talk to me.
Some do, some don't. I'm very leery about tipping because I always feel like I'm only tipping the server because the restaurant doesn't pay them a decent salary. That's the only reason I really do that.
I think that's why most people do.
Well, that's horrible. That's just kind of horrible. Because why am I paying their salary? It's part of, I don't tip anybody else in that restaurant. I don't tip the chef who's sweating into my food and really making it quite delightful and tasty. I'm not tipping him.
Well, then say they pay the servers a lot more money and they still get tipped.
I wouldn't tip. Then I wouldn't tip.
Some people still will, but it's been so long now. It's 2019. People have that mentality. You got to tip. You got to tip. So they're not going to stop. They're not going to know this waitress is making $15 an hour. Like minimum wage, and you tip her too?
And in some places, here's the other problem, Torrance. In some places, they pool the tips.
Yeah,
and at the end
do.
Of the night, they just divide them up.
Sure.
How unfair is
that?
Right,
because one girl worked harder than the other girl.
Exactly.
One girl had a party of 10, the other girl a party of 2.
Or the guy, let's be fair.
Yeah.
All right.
It happens.
It does happen a lot anymore, but it does happen. Yeah. But they should be pissed. They should be pissed. Like, I worked real hard. I'm splitting my tips.
I know.
The whole structure seems to be very haphazardly done. Right.
I worked in a restaurant for 2 years, and I saw this kind of stuff. They didn't do the tip pool thing, I don't think, but there's a lot of what's the word? Competition.
Sure, because
for these, they want this station, and they got that station, and they got a big party. I watched it happen all the time.
You're not getting a decent salary.
But the women are very. They get that way with each other too.
Not if they were just paid to do their freaking
job.
A
lot of gossipy dirt going on in restaurant server business. I'm telling
you. When you tip, you're creating commotion is what you're doing, And I understand that their job is to go to the counter, bring the food out of the kitchen, and put it on the table in front of you.
Mm-hmm.
Amazing performance.
you know.
In the long run, it's really good.
Well, I would
stupid.
Bring personality if I were a server.
Right.
You got to have that, you know?
Yes.
Chat them up, be funny.
Some of them go a little over. Well, if you're a guy, how much are you going to chat them up?
Well, you know, there's actually a restaurant. Mm-hmm. I think it's down south somewhere, maybe Texas.
Yeah.
But anyway, their whole bit is like a sarcastic.
Oh.
Have you seen that on the internet? And people think it's real. And they're like, wow, she was really rude. No, you go in there and they get as rude as
they
can
be.
I will love that. I want to do that.
No, you don't.
I want to call people names because I'm paid to.
Look.
What?
You're not paid. First of all, I don't know how you get tips like that.
Because it's the whole theme of the restaurant.
When I first moved to the Boston area.
Mm-hmm.
I had never been here before, except just for traveling and stuff.
You're from New York, I know.
Right, from New York.
New York, Jersey.
So I'm going to Faneuil Hall, where everybody goes when they're first coming to Boston.
Sure.
And I go to a place called Durgan Park.
Yep.
It's second floor of the Faneuil Hall thing.
Mm-hmm.
And apparently, and I didn't know this, it's got a reputation for doing exactly what you said. They're actually rude and crass.
Well, that's a reputation.
Correct. I did not know the reputation. They come to the table, they are like... I thought, well, I made a wrong move here. This is like a horrible, horrible city.
No, I get that. But I'm talking about this is a theme restaurant.
Where
people go in there expecting it. That's the whole draw. People, they want to get insulted and call like, oh, you could use some dessert. Yeah, right. That's what people are going in there. It's on YouTube. Look it up. It's a themed restaurant.
They fat shame you?
Everything.
And then you tip them?
Yeah, because that's why you're in there. That's the promo of the whole restaurant. They go in there to humiliate people.
Why? Well, I'll ask you because you want to go in.
Oh, I want to humiliate everyone. This would be awesome.
I'm
good at it.
But that's only if you're working there.
If you're working there, yes.
Well, of course. But why would somebody go there as a customer is my point.
Because they want the comedy.
That's not funny.
To your friends it is.
That's not funny.
Oh, bring your heavy friend in.
Oh, that's hard. Sorry. My God, what planet is this?
I don't know.
This is like
it's not around here. I'd go there and visit myself and go
That's
get waited
horrible.
On. And I'd let them tear me down. You go for it, girl. Do it. Bring it.
That is awful.
I look like a lesbian or something. Tell me.
You know, you can never walk
away
from that.
That's the best you could do anyway. I would be like, thank you.
Maybe you're laughing, but you're not laughing with somebody. You're laughing at somebody.
But they want it. That's what the point of the place is.
Oh, my God. Who would want humiliation?
Watch the video. It's hilarious.
These are sick people. They're Trump supporters.
But, you know, it's funny because people the comments under these, some of them people don't know it's what they're supposed to do. And they think, wow, I would have walked out. I would have done this. That's rude. She should get fired.
Yes.
No, she got hired for that purpose.
Oh, man.
I think it's a great themed restaurant.
I would love to work there, too. That's not the point, but I would not like to be a customer. I would question why.
Yeah,
what are you doing here?
I know.
Why would you want to put up with this shaming?
Because you do.
What's the name of the place?
I don't know.
Let me know. Text me and
I'll send you the video.
Don't call me because I'm going to block you.
Yeah, no, don't. I don't take a chance now.
No,
like I ever call you. Like I ever call anyone.
Yeah.
If my boyfriend phone rings, he goes, "Oh my God, she's calling me." He really, because we just text.
Something's wrong. Something's wrong.
Yeah,
something's
he does. We just
horribly
text.
Wrong.
Yes. We only text.
Right. I've been stopped. I've been arrested for swerving on the street over the lines.
I screwed up.
I screwed up.
You screwed up, man.
That is a federal offense, by the way. Screwing up.
It is. It's horrible. It's early retirement.
You didn't get
this
a screw up warning. Screw
up.
No screw up warning.
Well, he was in the middle of directing, pretending to be a construction.
Right.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
You move. I will point to you, and I shall yield power to make you stop your vehicle.
But I did. I did pass wind right before.
Certainly. Good.
He.
I would have done it during.
It was awesome. It was gross.
You would have been out of there a lot faster, man.
I opened the window and I'm like, okay, dude, here it comes. You're making me open this window, right? You're agreeing to this? Okay. And that's probably why I let me go.
You
just screwed up. Right. Never mind the seatbelt. Just get out of here.
You got some bad pot, Neely. You've been smoking? What the hell is that stuff?
Well, what do you think about passing gas in front of a stranger?
Love it.
No, really. I mean, like,
what?
I'm a woman and there's a strange man in the room but someone I don't really know that
I would never pass gas in a room where there was just two people. I would only pass gas where there's two or more.
So you could don't know who. No, but you misunderstand.
It would never be me.
Yeah, you misunderstand what I'm saying, right, which is awesome because I totally get that.
You're welcome.
But I mean audibly.
Oh, audibly, no. No. Oh, God, no. That has to be a mistake. No. There's ways to control the volume. And sometimes
pump up the volume. Pump up the volume.
No, there are ways. I mean, maybe I'm good at it. There are ways to let it seep out, and there are ways to make it well known to mankind.
Okay,
right.
So I'm a well known to mankind kind
yes.
of person.
Oh,
so but see how you just went? Oh,
I'm a who the hell did that kind of guy.
I can go both ways,
oh,
actually.
That's good
but
for
I
you.
Mean, like I try to make my boyfriend like go, oh my God. So I make it loud when other people
yes.
are around,
yes.
and he gets a little annoyed.
Yes.
Because if it's a man, he thinks that's being too familiar. And then men are going to think, oh.
All right.
Is that true?
So, wait, you actually.
Yes or no?
No, it's not a yes or no answer. So you actually find pleasure in doing the loud one.
Yeah.
Anytime you want.
No, not anytime I want. But under certain circumstances.
Yes.
Because I just have a lot of gas.
Give me a circumstance.
I have a lot of gas. I all day, every day, I'm
flatulent. I do, too. I do, too. We're sisters.
Compadre.
Right.
Simpatico.
Whatever country you're from. But I can control.
Oh,
the,
I can control.
So what are you saying?
Who can't control? I'm not a goose. I don't walk around. Blah, blah, blah. So, you know.
So why do you make it loud?
For comedy effect.
Oh, I see. Boyfriend, you're a saint. Boyfriend, you don't have to perform three miracles. You just performed one big one.
And
good
he just,
for you.
He looks at me. I've done it. Listen,
I don't blame him.
Listen, no, my mother one
it's
day,
awful.
My mother was there and my brother and me.
There's two reasons
and him,
for that.
And I made it loud and he just looks at me and his jaw hangs open and they know.
I don't blame him. First of all, if it's a stranger, they're going to assume it's him. And that's embarrassing. And it's wrong. And it's wrong, by the way.
I assume it's him.
Yes.
We had a thing about that in CVS.
Sure. There you go. No,
I went in one aisle, and then the next aisle, I followed him and did it again as loud as can be. And he got mad because he said,
God,
they're
going to
see little you
mad.
And big me, and they're going
to
say.
He might have to pick a prescription someday. He's got to go back
in
there.
Oh, it's his store, too.
Yeah, I know. That's the problem.
Yeah, I think it's funny. See, we're laughing.
Tori,
these are laughs.
No, that's
these are
not
the jokes.
Laugh. No, this is not funny. You should stop doing that. As a friend, don't do that.
But how else am I going to get my lulls?
I don't know. There must be some other way.
I'm already laughing now. It's a funny topic.
It's funny. You can say it happened, but it didn't. That would be funny. But to actually...
I wonder what the audience thinks of me right now. I don't care what you think of me because this is me.
They don't know you.
You know what?
They don't know you. It's not a big deal.
Like it'll lump it.
Have you ever had CBD oil?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
I vaped it. And of course, now I guess I can't vape.
Well,
didn't they ban that?
You really shouldn't vape anyway.
I'm going to do it now just because they said I can't. No, I'm not. I've had it. I used to vape.
Yeah. It's vaping is smoking.
Anyway, it depends on what you're vaping. I didn't vape nicotine.
Any smoke going
into your... Most people vape nicotine. No, I did not, believe it or not.
But you're still vaping...
I am. A substance or just plain. It can just be whatever. I'm drowning myself slowly.
Yeah.
It's water.
I know. I know at a point it doesn't matter anymore, but still, you should go on a theory.
Right.
I'm wondering...
I made those big clouds, too.
Yeah.
I was proud of that.
It's always attractive.
It is.
I'm wondering if someday within the next maybe 2 years or something... there'll be a report that says, like with vaping, CBD oil, it never worked.
It's just snake oil.
It's exactly it.
Right. Maybe.
It was a Trump thing.
It was a placebo effect?
Yeah.
Right.
Because I've tried CBD oil in various forms.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing, man. Nothing.
It relaxes me. It makes me very tired. I don't like the fact that I'm tired and I can't do a lot of stuff.
Really?
I'm tired anyway, I guess, so maybe it's just me.
I don't think it really does. And I know a lot of people who are starting to express this to me, that the CBD oil, Ron, does that really work for you? And my response is, well, kind of really no.
Right.
Not for $40, $60 a bottle.
Right.
I mean, it's someone's, I think, pulling a fast one. And if it's not everybody, it's most of them.
Okay.
I think it's like very similar to fortune tellers, those places you go to have your cards read and stuff.
Yeah, yeah. Yep.
There might be one or two that kind of really are like scary, but the other 72,000 of them, not really.
They're just trying to make money.
Yeah. But we all believe that crap.
Yeah.
But it's not, I think we all know.
Well, if it believes you and makes you feel better, like religion, then why not just go with it?
There's your CBD. But yeah. I'm not paying $40 a bottle for religion.
Well, if it made you feel better, you might. But you said it doesn't, so don't.
No, it doesn't. No.
Your head's not in the game. That's
a lot of money. It's a lot of money.
That's all right.
Did you ever buy clothes?
Yep.
I don't mean there's a personal...
I do.
I'm kind of... We have laws about everything. We have no laws about clothes. Because if it's like a size 10...
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
It could be 10. It could be...
they have SML, small, medium, large. Then they have things for women of the size 2, 4, 6, Tori, 8, 10. They go numbers.
But if it's your size and you try, especially pants, shoes,
sure.
You try them on, it's the same size,
yeah.
But they, they run different.
Yeah,
that's the excuse.
It's the manufacturing,
they
run. I think.
That's where there needs to be some semblance of agreement.
Okay, right.
What's the point of putting... So the sizes are just a possible suggestion it may fit.
Yeah, that's why you do something called try it on.
Yes.
You know?
And not order it from Amazon, send it back.
Yeah, or send it back.
Some of the Amazon stuff, by the way, you can't send back anymore. You have to go to various locations to return.
Oh.
They're starting that up.
Oh. Well, then just go... I don't know.
I don't know how Amazon can put up with all these returns.
I don't know either.
Although a lot of them go back to the manufacturer. And
that guy's got too much money anyway, Bezos.
He really does. Let's split that baby up.
He's kind of cheap, I heard.
I don't know. I mean, congratulations for doing what you did. See, I always think when you start acquiring other companies, shut up. You know, like make your company as big as the earth if you can.
Mm-hmm.
But don't go buying up other companies. Then you start to...
He's a little greedy. He's a little greedy.
It's more than greedy. You're starting to put your smell on everything, and it's like, okay.
That's ego, again.
It is ego.
Right.
But I don't want you owning everything and putting your twist on everything and taking away from what used to be a separate company that I happened to have previously enjoyed.
Yeah, like Bank of America swallowing up all the banks.
Yeah.
Like it says in the end times, in Revelations in the Bible, that's going to be the final bank.
It does mention Bank of America in the Bible.
Yeah, it mentions
a money system
that will be universal.
Yeah.
And we have to whittle it down. Yeah. They used to swallow up all those little banks with a note
the
names.
The last line in the book of Genesis is, what's in your wallet?
It was.
Yeah.
Was it the guy saying it from the TV show?
No. It was a prophet. For-profit organization.
I see what you did there.
It was for-profit.
You should trademark that. for profit.
This doesn't work in radio.
I know. We're doing air quotes, people.
That's what we're
doing.
In case
you didn't figure it out.
Air quotes.
You know what? I stopped drinking coffee.
Good for you.
You know how long it took me? A day.
There you go.
Where's the struggle, people? Stop it. I've been drinking green tea for a week. I feel no side effects.
Well, green tea has caffeine in it, too.
Whatever.
Okay.
You know what? The 400 milligrams of caffeine is the limit you're supposed to have. Right. Green tea has 35 milligrams. One cup a day. Wow.
Okay.
You know, I didn't even drink coffee all day long. I drank one cup a day.
All right. So you really can't use yourself as a pilot program.
I'm just saying, how hard is it to stop drinking coffee? People that struggle, I can't stop drinking coffee.
Yeah, but they're having more than one cup
of they're all day long
day.
With it. Right, so well, why should I bother? Why should I bother at all just stopping my one cup a day?
Why did you?
For my health.
All right.
Isn't tea healthier than coffee?
It's questionable. It's not.
Matcha. I drink matcha tea, to be specific.
All right. I don't think it's a tea. Actually, coffee has been known to be actually quite healthy for you and have many benefits.
Makes your teeth yellow. I don't think it does.
That's smoking.
And caffeine. And the coffee.
And too much banana.
Black coffee.
Okay. Well, that's if you're British.
No.
No, they all have benefits, but once you start putting sugar and cream or milk or something like that in it, you're not drinking coffee anymore. You're drinking that
like
crap.
A milkshake.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Whatever, man.
That's all I'm saying.
So I stopped my coffee. Big deal.
I use it to go to the bathroom. If I feel that I'm bound up, too much cheese, I'll have a couple cups of coffee, and it's like I just had a colonic.
Right.
Yeah.
I
got to have one of those.
Either way.
In
it's
October,
not affecting
I
got to
have one of those deals.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
That's coming up.
Yeah, they say once every like 3-5 years or something.
5 years. Do you drink that whole big gallon of stuff? I gave up on that.
I did. No, I gave up on that too. I found it not tasty. Yeah,
it made me sick.
The other one
is the little bottles of magnesium something.
That's what I'm supposed to do.
That's what I'm doing. I do those now.
Yeah, you used to do the Gatorade thing.
Yeah, that's nonsense.
I did it twice, and the second time
I was vomiting.
Yeah.
I said, I'm never doing
it.
The first time it was okay. It was like a garden hose comes out your butt.
I've never done the little bottles of stuff, and I have to let it. I was warned. Let the bottle open and let the fizz go away because it's carbonated.
Oh, let it go flat.
Yeah. They said
I didn't know that.
Yeah. I mean, I'm sure it helps the process along faster if you're gassy. But then you got to repaint the walls. I'm gassy enough.
We've discovered, we went over that.
I don't need any extra right there, especially in a situation like that.
Right. Yeah.
I think. So I don't know what's going to happen with that. It's not the camera crew. It's the prep.
I'm happy to take that Michael Jackson drug and go to sleep. Propololol?
I don't, we're adults.
Yeah.
I don't understand where after all these decades of sticking tubes up your ass, they can't come up with something that is
easy. But you swallow a camera and it goes through.
Well, something, I mean, I don't mind. I like to clean myself out, to be honest with you.
Yeah,
I think that's a nice idea.
That's right, it is.
But why does it have to be so uncomfortable? Why not something where you drink and you go, oop, okay.
Yeah, you got to live in the bathroom for hours.
I know.
Get a pillow in there.
I've never done this thing that we're talking about, this little bottle thing. I don't know what's going to happen with that.
It's effective. Maybe not as effective as the other, but it's fine.
Okay.
It was the old school one. They discovered the Gatorade thing about 10 years ago, and everybody switched.
I don't think they care if there's a little crap in there.
They notice it. They bring it up.
They still do it.
They bring it up. They said you could have been cleaner.
Yeah.
I've heard it mentioned.
They bring it up.
I've heard it mentioned.
Can I say something to you? You could have been cleaner.
They did. They didn't say it exactly that way, but there's something to that effect.
To be honest with you,
it was residual.
It was not that much fun for me.
It was residual. That's all we're saying. It wasn't a clean trap. I know you're a little pressive, but, can you do better?
Next time, drink a little slower. I don't know what to tell you.
I have lots of kinks and curves in my bowel. That's, too bad for me.
Oh, I think we all have little kinks and curves.
Minor. I have diverticulosis also.
Well, that doesn't make any difference.
I have little pockets everywhere.
It's a flexible hole.
Things go in there, seeds, they could, ferment.
Whatever.
It's an amusement park in there. I don't know. I don't want to know.
It's an amusement park.
It's not fun. It's abandoned. I mean, it's being condemned.
Tall. Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
What time do you think?
Ooh, 40.
I'm a little off.
All
right, fine.
A little off. Well, we started.
Yeah.
I was trying to compensate for all the...
Okay.
We didn't start this right away, folks, by the way.
No, there were some problems in the beginning.
Technical issues.
You might even caught it yourself, in the last attempt. Anyway.
It's kind of
fun.
All right. It's fun.
Well, this has been adorable. Do you have anything else?
It's been adorable. It's too long.
Yeah.
I'll save it for next week because it's not timely. It's just something that's not timely. Nothing's but someone really mentioned timely. It to me, and I thought, I'll bring that up on the next podcast. Sorry, Anthony. It'll be the very next podcast.
Interesting. Ooh, you mentioned a name.
He knows who he is, but he doesn't even listen. But that's all right. I said I was going to probably talk about this.
His name is Anthony.
Right.
Do you call him Anthony?
Yes.
If you're familiar with him, why wouldn't he be Tony?
Some people really like Anthony as opposed to Tony. You know?
Yeah.
Tori, Victoria.
Yeah.
I can do either.
I never understood how Bob came out of Robert.
I've heard Rob and Robbie also.
Yeah.
But Bob. Yeah.
There's a lot going on with that name. Robbie. Bobby.
Yeah, yeah.
Rob.
Wow.
Ert. There's a lot of...
There are.
I think that's the one that captures the most.
Yeah.
Then there's Jim and James.
Jamie.
Jamie too?
Mm-hmm.
I know a guy that loves to be called James. He doesn't want to be called Jim.
Yeah, my son was James. He liked James. It was it's James Bond.
Yeah. I like James. Yeah. I like the formal names except for mine. I don't like my formal name at all. No.
A clown adopted that. It's too late for you now.
I know.
You can't have that.
Well, you have the same situation.
mine's Regal.
Yeah, it is Regal.
I'm happy with my full name.
If you use the full one. Yeah.
And my boyfriend does.
Good.
If it's not honey. Every 5 seconds. We're honey.
Yeah.
But otherwise, it's my name, yeah.
Yeah. Huh.
Everybody's a honey, though. You got to get right to that. Once you're at that, you can't go back.
No.
Unless you're mad.
You should turn around and say, you're talking to me?
When someone's annoyed you, they use your name, though.
I know. Yeah, you did something wrong. Oh, you swerved on the line that was painted.
I screwed up.
Is that what the cop said?
He said, I screwed up. Buddy, if you knew me, you'd be like, that's the least of my screw-ups.
What are you going to do?
What are you going to do?
Well, this has been fun.
I guess so.
Next week?
Next week.
Next Monday?
Next Monday. It'll be October.
Right.
Will it?
Yeah. No, not quite.
One more day.
Not quite.
30 days, half September. April, June, and November.
It will be.
It'll be September 30.
Today's the 30th.
Oh, so.
So next week would be
October. Are you sure?
Yes.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
I'm lost.
So
just edit this all up, please.
Oh, my God. Unlisten.